Welcome to the Krishna in West Germany channel. And today I want to react to a song that a friend just sent me. And he said, hey, this song is called Little Blue. And I listened to the lyrics and could you check out if the whole song has maybe something to do with Lord Krishna, or to be precise, with little Lord Sri Krishna. As we know from the Bhagavata Purana, which I have here a German copy, the Srimad Bhagavatam, we know that the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Krishna, called in the Vedas, he has appeared 5,000 years ago, approximately, in a small village near New Delhi today, let's say 200 kilometers, a small village called Vrindavan at the river Yamuna. Lord Krishna appeared there 5,000 years ago, and he appeared there as a quote-unquote normal human being, but he performed very exalted divine activities never seen before in history, and for sure it will not be seen in the future. For instance, he lifted a whole mountain for 7 days at the age of 7 years. So let's check this song out by Jacob Collier, Little Blue. Nice setting, probably a church. Yeah, it's a church. And are these listeners or is it a choir?
Little blue.
Oh, beautiful.
Be my shelter. Be my cradle. Be my womb. Be my boat.
Okay.
Be my river.
Yeah, maybe some thoughts that just pop up. He sings, Little Blue, be my shelter. That's exactly what I told you. He lifted a whole mountain in the air for 7 days because a very powerful demigod, a deva called Indra, you can compare it to Lord Zeus, he somehow was angry with the inhabitants of that village, and his plan was to destroy the whole village with all the land, with all the cows and animals. So he constantly let rain pour down and massive clouds. And after some hours, the whole area was practically more and more underwater. And the inhabitants of Vrindavan, they had no other shelter. They thought Krishna, amongst in their midst, was a normal little boy. But somehow they understand he was the Supreme Personality of Godhead. And when some dangerous moment happened, they spontaneously took shelter. They requested Krishna to give them shelter. And when I just listened to his lyrics, Jacob Collier's lyrics, he says, Little Blue, be my shelter, be my cradle, be my womb, okay, be my boat, be my river. And that's also interesting. In the Bhagavad-gita, Lord Krishna gives a list of very powerful phenomena in the material nature, which are just like representatives of him. I will come to that later, but let's listen more to his very beautiful music for now. I think you also like his song. Please write it in the comments. What do you think about his very nice song here?
Be my boat, be my river, be the stillness of the moon.
Yeah, in the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says, amongst the sources of light, I'm the sun and the moon. So there are no more powerful sources of light than the sun and the moon. And also, he says, amongst the rivers and reservoirs of waters, I am the unlimited ocean. The ocean is practically endless. So that also reminds me of Lord Krishna's verses in the 7th chapter of the Bhagavad Gita.
If I could, I'd go with you to a place I never knew.
Okay, that's also, I don't know about you, but this totally reminds me of the Krishna philosophy, because Lord Krishna, he doesn't belong to this material world. This material world is temporary and full of suffering, Lord Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita 8.16. Abrahma bhuvana loka puna avatino juna mamupetya tu kaunteya puna janma na vidyate. And he says there that this material world is a place that is temporary, it won't exist forever, and it is full of suffering. Dukalayam ashashvatam. But those who come back to his spiritual abode, which is eternal, they will never take birth again in this material world. So I can very much imagine that a devotee, a bhakta of Lord Krishna, he will say, hey, I will just come with you and live with you at your eternal spiritual world or kingdom that is Sat Chit Ananda, that is full of Sat, which means eternal, that is Chit, full of consciousness, and that is Ananda, of everlasting, unlimited happiness and bliss.
In your eyes, so dark and open, there's a light that leads me back to you.
Okay, so of course we can imagine God has the most beautiful eyes. When the eyes are very dark, they can also be very beautiful. And he said that there's a light in the eyes. That's also interesting, because also in the Srimad Bhagavatam, it is said that the sun and the moon are like the two eyes of the Supreme Lord. And without those sources of light, nobody is able to see. So we need the eyes of God here in the material world, and the moon and the sun are the representatives. So that is interesting. And he even then says, or sings, this Jacob Collier, that Lord Krishna leads the singer back to his abode. That's my interpretation, folks. Write in the comments what do you think, and maybe Jacob himself is listening to my reaction video. So I would be very curious what his interpretation is of his song.
'Cause you're not so far away, I hear you say, you'll never walk alone.
Okay, very beautiful. So, interestingly, God, on one sense, God and his spiritual kingdom is very far away. We cannot reach it even with the most complicated spaceship. We cannot fly to the spiritual kingdom of God. But at the same time, Lord Krishna is in our hearts. So there is nobody nearer to us. That is also explained in the Sri Ishupanishad that he is at the same time far away, very far away, and at the same time most near, living in our or residing in our heart.
Singing, don't be afraid of the dark in your heart, you're gonna find a way to carry the weight of the world on your shoulders. You're gonna find your way.
Okay, that's really very beautiful. I think now, dear Jacob, please correct me if you listen to this. But now the singer is changing the perspective. In the first verse, he addresses that little blue. In my eyes, it is Lord Krishna. And now he's changing his perspective and he's addressing the living entity here in this material world. It can even be that Lord Krishna speaks now to the small living entity here in this material world and tries to give him appeasement, to give him shelter and what it is called, solace, by saying, don't be afraid of the dark in your heart. You're gonna find a way to carry the weight of the world. We all know that this world, it's really not an easy place here to live. We all have our problems and our challenges. So sometimes we really feel a burden here. We have to carry a lot of weight in this world on our shoulders. But he gives that solace. You're gonna find a way. So let's see. Now is probably coming verse number 2.
Little blue, be my anchor.
Yeah.
Be my light, my compass star.
Okay.
Be my darkness, be my danger.
Okay. So the first two lines I can easily say, little blue, be my anchor. Yeah, we can pray to God, please be my anchor, be my light, my compass star. That's easy to understand. And now let's check out this again.
Be my darkness, be my danger, be the strings of my guitar.
Okay. Be my darkness, be my danger. That is interesting. So I'm curious what Jacob really means by it. But it is a fact also described in the 10th canto of the Srimad Bhagavatam that the cowherd boys, the friends of Lord Krishna, they went out with him during the day and they were herding the cows and calves and they were looking for dangers and for adventures. Yeah, they were looking for dangerous situations because they knew inwardly that Lord Krishna will always help them out. So there are very nice pastimes. For instance, there was a big demon like a snake and the mouth was as big as a cave. And although the friends of Krishna, they knew that it is really dangerous to enter into a huge snake's mouth, but they were so confident that Lord Krishna will rescue them finally. So, and he did. So that is my interpretation. And be the strings of my guitar. That's also interesting that Jacob, that's my interpretation, folks, he knows, hopefully, that his ability to play very nice music is dependent also or empowered of God or by God. So let's see.
My danger, be the strings of my guitar. Little blue, how I love you, something strong.
Okay. I don't know, but for me that sounds very devotional, his outburst of how much I love you. That is really beautiful. When he really wrote that song for Lord Krishna, oh my God, then this is a real gem of devotion. So something strong and something true. Okay, let's continue.
In your eyes, so dear and gentle, there's a light that leads me back to you. 'Cause you're not so far away.
So again, it's a theme here in that song. He wants to go back to God. He wants to go back into the spiritual kingdom and wants to leave this material world for good. That's what I get from these lyrics here. So now let's continue.
'Cause you're not so far away. I hear you sing. Never walk alone.
So I think it's just confirmed what I previously said, that he's changing the perspective in the verse. He sings from the perspective of the jiva, of the living entity, and then he skips the perspective, and here now it is confirmed. The living entity hears Lord Krishna saying, "You will never walk alone." So,
singing, don't be afraid of the dark.
Wow.
In your heart, you're gonna find your way to carry the weight of the world.
My God, that's beautiful.
On your shoulders, you're gonna find your way.
You can see all these members of the choir. They are following in this particular mood, in this devotional mood.
Find your way.
Very nice atmosphere. You can really see these people, they are feeling something. Jacob Collier is famous for interacting with the audience, or in this case with the choir. He is not a one man, what it is called, a one man show. He wants to include as many people as possible, which I find very nice.
Don't be afraid of the dark in your heart. I'm gonna find your way.
Wow.
To carry the weight of the world on your shoulders. You're gonna find your
He's a brilliant singer.
Don't be afraid of the light. It's alright. You're gonna find your way to carry the weight of the world.
Okay. So he's now singing, "Don't be afraid of the light, it's all right." That's also interesting because in the Ishupanishad, which is the Upanishad dealing with the Isha, with the Ishvara, or with the Supreme Lord, in the later verses, the author says, in the 16th mantra, the author says, "Please remove the rays which are emanating from your body. These rays are very bright. It's called the Brahma Jyoti. And when the soul goes back to God, it is first, he is confronted with that divine light." But Lord Krishna here says, that's my interpretation, "Don't be afraid of that light, because when you go through that light and the light becomes removed, you can see the source of the light, and that is the Supreme Person."
Don't be afraid of the light. It's alright. You're gonna find your way to carry the weight of the world on your shoulders. You're gonna find your way.
So many people who had those so-called near-death experiences, they recall their experience that they were confronted with a divine, very bright light. So most of them, they regret coming back into their bodies because that light was so warm and so divine, and they wanted to follow that light. And as we know from the Krishna philosophy, when you follow that divine light, you will come finally to the supreme spiritual kingdom.
Find your way, find your way, find your
Bravo.
Cool. Thank you all.
That was very beautiful.
Beautiful.
Thank you. Yeah, okay. So thank you, Jacob Collier, for this nice song. I am very inspired. And yeah, maybe he means something complete different. I am not 100% sure, but a devotee of Lord Krishna, he should see everything with Krishna conscious eyes and hear everything with Krishna conscious ears. So even if he means something complete different, I can't help but I get this information for me. And please write in the comments, what do you think? Am I totally wrong? Or is it a way to look at this song or to hear that song? And is that probably what Jacob Collier means here with these beautiful lyrics packed in this beautiful musical arrangement? So he has all my 5 stars. And yeah, if you like this reaction video, please give us a thumb upwards. And if you haven't subscribed the Krishna in West Germany channel, then it's high time. And see you in our next video. Namaste, have a nice day. Hare Krishna.